It was the Frenchman Nicéphore Niépce who conducted the first experiments aimed at harnessing the chemical process. The technique he used required several hours exposure time, so for photographic purposes it was of very limited value. News of Niépce's work reached the ears of Louis Daguerre. In 1835, 2 years after Niépce's death, Daguerre entered his studio to make preparations for a photograph. Extremely long exposure times were still a big problem. To make maximum use of the available light, Daguerre used a mirror to reflect the sun's rays. Even so, it still took around 8 hours to obtain a visible image on the photographic plate. His simple camera showed the subject upside down. Daguerre removed the ground glass screen that served as a viewfinder and took the light-proof box containing the photographic plate out of the laboratory cabinet. When the cover was removed from the box, exposure began. Then it was a question of waiting for several hours. Suddenly, dark clouds appeared in the sky and blotted out the sun.
Yet.
Daguerre had no choice. Exposure had to be interrupted. He removed the plate from the camera and put it back in his chemicals cabinet. The next day, Daguerre returned to the studio to start again, intending to reuse the briefly exposed plate. Just to check it was still serviceable, he opened the box. To his amazement, he found himself looking at the previous day's motif. Some chemical substance in the cabinet must have developed the plate overnight. As Daguerre subsequently discovered, the developing agent was mercury vapour. It was the breakthrough Daguerre had been looking for. Development by mercury vapour reduced exposure times to minutes. A shoeshine boy and his customer were the first people to be photographically recorded, appearing as a detail in this boulevard scene.